Good morning, students. Now, in this part, we will understand how the numerical can be solved by using the concave lens. Last time we learned how can we obtain the images by using the concave lens. And this part, I am going to explain you how can we solve the numerical of concave lens. So first, for going with the numerical, first we should know how can we form the image by concave lens. I know I explained you in last lecture, but again, I am going to make a figure for you so that you can easily understand the sign convention of the concave mirror. Okay, this is the sign convention of the concave lens, sorry, not the mirror, concave lens. We know that concave lens has to focus each on either side, F1, F2, and then this is called a 2F. 2F means the twice of the focal length. Again, it is 2F2. So, if you put an object anywhere like this, I am placing an object here. So, one ray which is parallel to the principal axis will appear to be diverse from this focus, like this, and other will pass from the optical center and passes straight without any deviation. So, this is the image formed by the concave lens. And you should know that the distance of the object from the lens we always represent by symbol u. And the distance of the image from the lens we always represent by the symbol V. And F is the focal length. H1 is the height of the object and H2 is the height of the image. So in this figure, we know that if you place anywhere this object in case of concave lens, the image will always formed virtual, erect and is smaller than object. So this is the distance of the object from the lens. And we know that if we measure the distance towards this side, that is towards the left side, it is always negative. So we will say the distance of the object from the lens is negative. It means u will be negative. You will say u is negative. And the focal length, we always use this focus in this concave lens. So we can say the focus is, again, it is negative. Since we measure the distance of the focus towards this side of the optical center, so it is negative. And what is about the H1? Our H1 is always positive because object is always erect. So we will say it is positive. What is about the V and the H2? Image formed is always virtual, erect. So we will say that V will be always negative. Negative signs show that the image is virtual. Okay. And second thing is, what is about the H2? That is the height of the object. Image. So we know that image is always erect. So we will say the H2 will be positive. It means the image is erect. So these are the sign convention for the concave lens, and it is fixed. It do not changes at any condition. In any condition. So first, okay. First, I am going to tell you the uses of the concave lens. What are the uses of the concave lens? We use the concave lens for the correction of the defect of vision, that is called the myopia. In case of myopia, we are not able to see the far object. We are able to see the nearby object clearly, but we are not able to see the far objects. So these type of defect of vision is called the myopia. So most of the children have the defect of vision, that is called the myopia. So for the correction of myopia, we use concave lens. How it works, I will explain you in the next chapter, that is the human eye. So first, the use of concave lens, we use it for the defect of vision called the myopia. So in spectacles, we use the concave lens. Other uses of the concave lens is, we use the concave lens in telescope for seeing the far object like the stars, etc. And other uses of the concave lens is, concave lens also uses, let me see, it is also used, okay, in most of the optical instruments they use the concave lenses. So these are the uses of the concave lens. Now, since I have explained you what are the sign convention of the concave lens, I am going to give you one example of the numerical of the concave lens. So let me rub it. I hope that you write it. You have written it in your notebook. So this is one of the question. An object placed 50 cm from a lens produces a virtual image at a distance of 10 cm in front of the lens. Object placed 50 cm from the lens. It means this is the distance of the object from the lens, which is always negative. So we will say u is equal to minus 50 cm. Produce a virtual image at a distance of 10 cm in front of the lens. So since the image is virtual, so we will say v is equal to minus 10 cm. Draw the diagram to show the formation of the image. Calculate the focal length of the lens and the magnification produced. Okay. So one thing is, since the image is virtual, so we will say v is minus 10, because for the virtual images we represent it by the negative sign. We will use a lens formula, that is 1 upon f is equal to 1 upon v minus 1 upon v. This is the lens formula. In convex lens, I explained you this lens formula. This is the lens formula. And what is the magnification? Magnification is the ratio of the height of the image to that of the object. It's the same for the mirror and the lens. That is h2 upon h1. But in case of lens, it is also equal to the v upon u. In case of mirror, we know that it is equal to the minus v upon u. But in case of lenses, it is equal to the v upon u. So this is the magnification of lenses. And in case of lens, what the sign of magnification show, like if the image is virtual, like in the case of the concave lens, if the image is virtual, it means the h2 is positive, because virtual image is always erect, and h1 is positive, it means magnification will be positive. So if magnification is positive, you will say that the image is virtual. We know that the virtual image is always erect. And if the magnification is negative, so in case of negative, we know that h1 can't be negative at any time. So h1 is always positive. M will be negative if h2 will be negative. So when h2 will be negative, when the images become inverted. And in which case the inverted images form? Always real image is inverted. So we will say M negative is the real image. So this is all about the sign convention and the relation. Magnification and between v and u and magnification, and this is the lens formula. So we will apply this lens formula. 1 upon f is equal to 1 upon v, that is minus 10, minus 1 upon minus 50. 1 upon f is equal to, it is 1 upon, that is minus 1 upon 10, and minus 1 is plus 1 upon 50. By taking LCM, we will get 1 upon f is equal to 50 is LCM. Minus 5 plus 1. It will be now 1 upon f is equal to minus 4 upon 50. So what is the value of f? F is equal to minus 50 upon 4. Or we can say it is equal to the 4 value of 4. 4 is 8, 2.5 centimeter negative. What does negative sign show? This negative sign show that this is a concave lens. Because we know that the convex lens have always positive focal length. So negative focal length means the lens is concave. And so we can obtain the image by concave lens. Like, even though we can take the scale for this question, like we can take as 10 cm is equal to 1 cm. So this is the concave lens, and we can take the focal length is 12.5. So we can, if we are taking 10 cm equal to 1 cm, then it will be 1.2 cm. So okay, the focal length is 1.2. This is double focus. So we are placing the object at since, okay, like one more thing, focal length is 12.5 and we are placing the object at 50. It means we are placing the object beyond 2f. Because 2f will be 25, and we are placing the object and twice of that 2f. That is, we are placing the object beyond 12. So we will place object like this. Okay, I have to rub this part of question for obtaining the image. So I think it should be clear to you, that is, since f is 12.5, 12 will be 25. And we are placing the object at 50. It means we are placing the object at between infinity and 12. So the one ray will come parallel, will appear to diverge from focus. Other will be come towards the optical center. Okay, sorry. You can't use the scale here. So this is the image form. Okay, so you can show that this is the image form, and this is of 10 centimeter. So this is the image form by the concave lens. Again, in the question we also have to calculate the magnification produced. Okay, so we know the formula for the magnification is equal to V upon U. V is how much? It is minus 10 and U is minus 50. So sorry, it is V upon U, yes. So magnification is 1/5. Okay, so this is the numerical of concave lens, and I think it should be clear that magnification of concave lens is always positive. Now you will do most of the numerical of concave lens, and in case of any problem you can ask me in your Zoom class. So now I'm going to complete this chapter by explaining the last part of the chapter. It is the power of a lens. Power of a lens. So let me drop this board for explaining the next part. It is the power. So first you should know what is the power of a lens. This is not the power of, like, in physics we learn about the power is equal to work done upon time. So this is not the power of a lens. So what is the power of a lens? Power means the converging or diverging capability. It means these are two lenses. I am going to explain you by taking two examples. This is a thick lens and this is a thin lens. And obviously, this thick lens has less focal length. Yeah? This is a thick lens and it has a less focal length. And this is a thin lens and it will have a large focal length. It's okay. So now what happens if the light comes parallel to each other, like this? Obviously it will converge towards the focus. Okay. Same thing with this lens. The light is coming like this, parallel to the principal axis, and this lens will also converge the light beam, light rays towards the focus like this. Which lens have the great ability to converge the light rays? Obviously this one. It converges the light rays more as compared to this lens. It means a thick lens converges the light rays more as compared to the thin lens. Why? Because it has a less focal length. And this lens, since this lens has a large focal length, so it converges the light rays less as compared to this lens. So it means the converging power is depend on the focal length. And larger the focal length, less the converging power. And the smaller the focal length, larger the converging power. So we can say the power of a lens, the power of convergence or the divergence, depend on the focal length. And this power we represent by the symbol P, and it is reciprocal of the focal length. The important condition is focal length should be meter. So this is the power. Power means the power of convergence of divergence or divergence of a lens. It's called the power of a lens. And it totally depends on the focal length. But it is reciprocal of the focal length. By increasing the focal length, we decrease the power of a lens. or by decreasing the focal length, it increase the power of lens. So we can say power is the power of lens is the measure of degree of convergence or divergence of a lens. So in case of convex lens, we can say the power of convergence, or in case of concave lens, we will say the power of divergence of a lens. So this is called the power. This is the formula for the power, and the important condition is the focal length should be in meter. So you will say the reciprocal of the focal length in meter is called the power of a lens. What is the SI unit of power? The SI unit of power of a lens is diopter. Diopter is the SI unit of power of a lens. We represent it by the symbol capital D. It shows the power of a lens. Okay. So we have some questions for the power. Again, one more thing I have to tell you, that the sign of the focal lens is also the sign of the power. Suppose convex lens. A convex lens has the power always positive. The focal length is always positive for the convex lens. So the power of the convex lens is also positive. And in case of concave lens, the focal length is always negative. So the power of lens is always negative. Okay. I think you have ever seen that the power of spectacles. If you have in spectacles, then it always has some power. So the power of a lens is like, this is the power of a lens, which is can be positive or can be negative. It depends on which type of lenses you are using in your spectacles. So mostly the children have the myopia. It means you are not able to see the far objects. You are able to see the near object clearly. So in case of myopia, we use the concave lens. It means the power should be negative. So, in case of myopia, we use the power of a lens which is negative. So, now I am going to explain you some questions. Question is, a convex lens having the focal length of 10 cm. So, it means the focal length is plus 10 cm for the convex lens. Now, what is the power of a lens? You will see the power is equal to 1 upon L, but the important condition is F should be in meter. So we will convert the centimeter to meter. 10 upon 100, it will be 1 upon 10 meter. So power is equal to 1 upon 10. It means 10 diopter plus 10 diopter. This is the power of lens. Again, if the focal length of the concave lenses, we know that it is always negative. So if the question is the focal length of concave lens is 10 centimeter, so even the focal length is minus 10 centimeter. Then power is equal to 1 upon F. Again, the F should be in meter. So you will say minus 10 upon 100 meter or minus 1 upon 10 meter. So what should the power of the lens is equal to 1 upon minus 1 upon 10. It means minus 10 diopter. So this is the power of the convex lens or the concave lens. And suppose if you have the power and you have to find the focal length, then again, you can use the same formula. The question is, third question. The power of a lens is minus 2.5 diopter. What is its focal length? Now the power is minus 2.5 diopter. Okay? You have to find the focal length. Again, the same formula is, F is equal to 1 upon P. So F is equal to 1 upon minus 2.5. We can solve it like 10 upon 25. Or this will be meter, because we use the focal length in meter for finding the power. Again, since you are finding the value of F is very less, so you can convert it into meter, centimeter, by multiplying it by 100. So it will be 25 × 100. It means minus 40 centimeters the focal length of the lens. Minus, I showed that it lenses concave. So these are some simple questions about the power of a lens. Now the power of combination of lenses. So this is the power of a lens. Power means the degree of convergence or divergence of a lens. Convergence for the convex lens and divergence for the concave lens. SI in the power is diopter. So, power of a combination of lens. Now, the power of combination is if you combine two or more lenses together, then how can we find the power of lens? So power of a lens we can find by the algebraic sum of the different power of lenses which we are using. Suppose we are using two lenses, one is convex and other is concave, and you have to find the combination, the power of this combination. Then you will add the power of both the lenses with their sign. Algebraic sum is the, we will add by using, by taking their sign with them. Like power is equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3. So this is the power of combination. For example, the focal length of a convex lens is, suppose I am taking it like 25 cm. Okay, it is positive because the focal length of convex lens is positive. And suppose the focal length of concave lens is minus 50, suppose. And now we have to find the combination, power of combination. So first you have to find the power of this convex lens. It will be power is equal to, I am writing it like P1 is equal to, it should be in meter. So we will say 1 upon 25 upon 100. It means 100 upon 25, positive. It is plus 4 diopter. This is the power of convex lens. And the power of this concave lens P2 is equal to 1 upon minus 50 upon 100. Again, focal length should be in meter. So it will be 100 upon 50. It is minus 2 diopter. So these are the power of the convex and the concave lens. Since we are combining these two lenses, so we will say the power of this combination will be plus 4 and minus 2. So we will add these power with their sign. It will be 2 diopter plus 2 diopter. So this is the power of the combination. So okay, let me take some more examples. The power of combination of two lenses is 5 diopter. So we have two lenses X and Y, and the power of the combination is 5 diopter. 5 diopter is positive sign. If the focal length of the lens is 15 cm. So X lens, the focal length of one of the lens is given, how much? 15 cm. Then you have to find the focal length of the other lens. So you will say that we know the focal length of the one of the lens. So what will be its power? Its power will be, this focal length should be in meter. So it will be 100, P is equal to 1 upon F. That is 1 upon 15 upon 100. It means this is the power of one of the lens. And suppose the other lens having the power P. Suppose. So the power of combination should be equal to the power of the one of the lens, that is 100 upon 50, plus power of the another lens, that is P. So we can find the value of P by calculating it. P is equal to 5 minus 100 upon 15, which will be 75 minus 100, that is minus 25 upon 50. So this is the power of the another lens. Then how can you find the focal length of this lens? Focal length is equal to 1 upon power. Again, if we are using this power, the focal length should become in meter. Yes. So it is 1 upon P means 15 upon 25 minus in meter. Again, you can change it into centimeter by multiplying it by 100. It will be minus 60 cm. It means the other lenses. Concave lens. So by saying the sign, what is the sign we have now? We can find the focal length. We can find which lens is used as a second lens. So one lens is the convex and the other one is a concave lens. So these are simple questions of this chapter. Now the chapter has completed. I have completed this chapter. And in your class, in your Zoom class, you can ask me any question about this chapter. okay?